Good morning. So my name is Hichem Ben Salem. I was the director of a research program at ICARDA. ICARDA is the International Center of Agricultural Research in the Dry Areas. It's one center among 15 others under the CGR system. The CGR is the consortium group agriculture, international agriculture research. So the mandate of ICARDA actually is working in the dry areas in North Africa, in West Asia, in Sub-Saharan Africa, in West Asia, as I mentioned, and also in Central Asia. So the main actually purpose of ICARDA is to provide some technology, some solutions to the farmers and communities living in the dry areas in terms of improving their livelihood, the productivity, the sustainability, and the resilience of the production systems. So in the dry areas, as you know, so agriculture plays an important role, even through the crops, through the livestock, and some other, let me say, sources of income. But the main challenges actually is to provide, as I mentioned, a package for these farmers that can help them coping with the drought, with the climate change also. So conservation agriculture is considered by ICARDA as one of the promising option that farmers in different categories, mainly the small farmers, can use to reduce the production cost and also to cope with the climate change. So as you know, conservation agriculture, it reduces, for example, the labor, it reduces the fuel, and also it can somehow improve the income of the farmers, but we should look also for the environment impact. Conservation agriculture, let me say, is a good solution to fix the soil and thus to reduce the erosion. So if I make the link between the mandate of ICARDA and this international course on conservation agriculture in the Mediterranean area, I would say that in the Mediterranean area there are different production systems and somehow we need some adjustment of the packages, of the approach to be adopted by these different production systems. So far, the conservation agriculture was introduced in the region since the 80s, even in the 90s in some other countries. But although this technology or farming type was introduced in some countries since the 80s, but still the adoption rate is somehow low. For sure, we need some fine-tuning of the technical, and practices for conservation agriculture at the level mainly of small farmers. But I think the most important is nowadays is to go for these institutional and policy options. So among the main obstacles of the adoption of conservation agriculture in the Mediterranean area, mainly at the level of small farmers, is the first thing is the high cost of seeders for zero tillage, which actually the small farmer cannot afford to buy and to purchase these seeders. The other main obstacle also in, in the Mediterranean area, mainly in the southern part of the Mediterranean, like in Tunisia, in Morocco, in Algeria, and in some other countries, the livestock is an important component in the system. But if we consider the principles of conservation agriculture, I think one pillar is that the residue management. So we have to somehow to leave some amount of residues of the stubbles on the ground to improve soil fertility. But in these countries, as I mentioned, mainly in North Africa, the livestock used to graze during the summertime. And to ask for the farmer to not allow his animals to graze on stubble is in itself an obstacle. So my intervention in this international course on conservation agriculture is to push towards the integration of crop, livestock, under conservation agriculture. So the integration actually is based on the recycling of all products which are produced either by the animal or by the crops, and to keep them within the production system, like the manure, like the residues, and so on. So the livestock in itself can have a positive also impact on conservation agriculture, on the system, through, for example, manure production to improve soil fertility. So, but we need, at the technical level, somehow to define the optimum stocking rate, to look for other alternatives to replace or at least to reduce the use of stubbles like forage, for example, productions. This could be like vetch and some other promising species. We can also look for the alternate grazing of rangeland, of stubbles, and so on. So I think there are some technologies which were recently developed in the Mediterranean area, either by ICARDA or some other countries, and think the solutions are there. But again, as I mentioned, I think the challenge now is to go for these institutional options, like, for example, farmers associations to manage actually these cedars and to help them purchasing these cedars. We also should go for the policy makers. We have to prepare ourselves as technicians, as NGOs, as a farmer association, as scientists also, to convince the policy makers to adopt and to develop some policies to push and to support the conservation agriculture in the Mediterranean area. So for sure, North Mediterranean and Southern Mediterranean somehow have different policies, but I think we should have a kind of exchange, knowledge exchange between the two regions, and also we should go also for upscaling. So the upscaling is not an easy task. Transfer of knowledge, some approach should be considered to guarantee actually the adoption at a large level of conservation agriculture by farmers in the different categories of farmers, but also across different production systems, whether it is agro-pastoral or irrigated or intensive rain-fed system. So I think the solutions are there, but we need, as I mentioned, some coordination among us as Mediterranean countries to work together, to exchange information, and also to develop some strategies to move forward with this interesting and promising technology, which is conservation agriculture. So I think the solutions are there, but what we need, as I mentioned, we have to work together.